Hey everybody, this is the first video blog update I've done. I've been trying to wait till my internet got a better quality, and so I've now been able to get a better internet. So now here we go. I'm going to try and do these, maybe not every blog update, but every pretty often I'm going to try and do it this way, just to do it in a different way and mix it up a little bit. But I wanted to say thank you so much for all your prayers. We had our first day of school finally after being here for a few weeks. We finally were able to have school for the first time today, and so that went really well. We had just a great time with the kids. It's been just a joy to see their smiling faces and their excitement. And so we're just really excited about what God has in store for this school year. I assisted with second and fifth grade English classes today. That's what I'll be doing until Wednesday. We have Thursday and Friday off because Honduras' Independence Day towards the end of this week, and so we'll have Thursday and Friday off. So we'll just have a 3-day school week. And so, but I assisted with second and fifth grade, and next week I'll be starting teaching my seventh and eighth grade, my combined class of seventh and eighth graders in the afternoons. And so I'm really looking forward to being able to teach them. And so I'll have my fifth and second grade classes that I'll be assisting with in the mornings, and then starting next week I'll be teaching that class of seventh and eighth graders. And so I'm really looking forward to this year. It feels just overwhelmingly great to finally be starting what God's called me to do here, and that's to teach at Destino del Reino. And so I'm really looking forward to this year. Another update is on the well at Destino. It's finally hopefully going to be finished this week, and so it's just been a long process of hoping they could fix the original well that broke, and then they realized they needed to dig another well. But thankfully, the new well will not have to be as deep as the original well, and they are able to get more water out of this new well, and so that's been a blessing. And so, as I said, it hopefully should be done by the middle of this week, but and so just pray for that to go well, that we can finally, after at least a few months at the ministry, they've been without running water, and so finally we're hoping we get some running water at the school and at the ministry as a whole. And so just be praying for that to go well. A big need for that though is the finances. That obviously they thought they were just going to be able to fix the well that was broke, but then they realized they needed to dig a whole new well, and so that's cost more money. And so actually just be praying about that, if God lays it on your heart to help the ministry with these costs that it's taken to fix the well and to build the new well. I'll be posting a link on this blog post. And if God lays it on your heart to make a donation, you'll be able to make that donation online, or you can mail it in to the ministry in Augusta, Georgia. But I'll be giving you that information. If you have any other questions too, just feel free to let me know. Another update is the container that I'm sure many of you back home in Vidalia, Georgia, and Lyons, Georgia, and Norco, Louisiana, the churches I was connected with that made donations to the container back in July, and had the collection drive going. You donated books and school supplies and clothes and all sorts of things. And hopefully the container will be here by the end of next week, so we're really hoping it'll get here soon. It's taken a little bit longer than I had originally thought, but it's looking like it should be here by sometime, hopefully this week, but it'll take at least 4 or 5 days to get it out of the port. That's not a very simple and easy process here in the country to get things out of the port. And so, but hopefully by the end of next week we should have it at Destino. We'll be able to finally get all the school supplies, because we've been having to scramble today, being the first day of school. Rhonda went earlier last week, had to go get some more notebooks, and we've had to kind of scramble around to get pencils and dry erase markers and all sorts of things. To just hold us over until the container gets here with all the tons of school supply. So I just pray for us to finally get that container next week, or at least within the next couple of weeks. Another reminder is of Carmen's blog that she has. You'll see at the top of my blog, you'll see a tab that says Carmen's blog, and that'll take you to a page that'll have her link, the link to her blog. I encourage you to just take a few minutes and check it out. And she's got some great recipes and then just some cooking tips and some videos. And she also just has, besides cooking, and just has her blog built around the concept of joy and how God can give you the joy in your life just through simple things, you know, that we may take for granted. And so she kind of just shares just how you can have joy in your life. And so I would just encourage you to check that out, and just feel free to leave her a comment or two, and just let her know what you think of, you know, a particular post that she has or just anything on her blog. Just encourage you to leave her a comment. I know she would appreciate that. Finally, I'll just close in with some prayer requests. As I've mentioned some of these again, but I'll just repeat some of them. But one thing, I just ask you to be praying for the middle school. As I said, well, I'll be starting my 7th and 8th grade class next week, and so for now, we'll be meeting in the main elementary school building and until the middle school is finished. And so they've been trying to work on getting at least the first floor done of the middle school, but that hasn't happened yet. And so just pray for the middle school to get finished soon, at least the first floor, so we can hurry up and get the middle schoolers in there. But as I said, for now, we'll be meeting in the main elementary school building. And so just pray for all that to go well, that the finances for the middle school building will keep coming in, and that the construction process will go smoothly and quickly, so we can hurry up and get the middle schoolers in there. And also, as I said, with the container, pray for it to get here around the 20th. That's the last date I've heard of an approximate or estimated date for us to finally get it to Destino. And so just pray for that to go well, that there won't be too long of a wait in the port, and that won't be too much of a hassle of the port officials saying, oh, well, we need this form signed, or we need this paperwork, or, oh, wait, we don't have enough money to get the container out, so we need more money. And a lot of times that's usually what happens, is it's never an easy and simple process. You can't just go to the port and get it out. It's usually at least a few days. And so just pray for that to go smoothly, and that we can hurry up and get the school supplies and the other supplies that are needed here at the ministry. And just for the start of the school year, as we start this new school year at Destino, just pray for God's blessings on the teachers and the students, and that He would just guide and direct them over these next coming months, and that they would just be excited to learn about science and math and English, and that they would be even more excited to learn about Him through the Bible classes we'll have, and then we have a devotion time on Monday mornings, and that God would just be able to just shine through the teachers, and that the light of Christ would just shine brightly through the teachers and their words and their thoughts. And you know, we were able to share our testimonies with some of the classes today as we were doing our introductions, and that was just a great way for them to be able to see Jesus in us and what has happened in our lives since we've accepted Christ as our Lord and Savior. And so just pray for boldness for the teachers and strength for the teachers, and just that the students would be receptive, and that they would just continue to have a joy for learning. As we saw just their smiling faces this morning, and you just see their excitement to learn and to grow. And I just pray that you would just pray along with me for these students, and that they would grow in a way that just lets their family members see it, and their friends see it, and that they would truly know that they are being loved by God, and that it would just overflow into the lives of many people here. Speaking of students, I pray that you just take some time to pray about it, sponsoring a student. We still need a lot of students to be sponsored, and so I just ask you to just take the time to pray about that with whether it be your spouse or your children, or if you're just a single adult, that you just take some time to pray about that and see what God would have you to do, if He would have you to sponsor a child. And you can do anything from a half sponsorship, which is $30 a month, to a full sponsorship, which is $60 a month. And not only does that monthly payment go towards the overall cost, it goes to help some of the overall costs and expenses of the ministry as a whole, but it goes to helping your particular student. And it gives you an opportunity to have one student, or if you sponsor 10 or 20 students, however many students you feel led to sponsor, that you know you have a particular student that you can pray for and that you can truly reach through prayer and doing it that. And that's probably, there's no probably, that's the best thing you can do for your student is pray for them and their family. So just encourage you to do that, and I'll be posting a link to the website for you to be able to do that if you feel led to do that. And so anyways, I just want to thank each and every one of you for your prayers and support, and I'm looking forward to continuing on this journey until next June, and I'm looking forward to taking you along with you, taking you along with me. And so I'm just excited, and again, thank you so much for your prayers and support, and I'm looking forward to keeping on. And so let's go. Let's take the love of Christ to these kids and to the people of Honduras. All right. See you guys later. Bye.